Coming up, we're going to take a look at deploying and managing Microsoft 365 powered devices with capabilities that make it possible for you to be able to auto-provision new devices using Windows Autopilot and deliver apps and services including Office 365, ProPlus, and line of business apps. We're going to make it so that you can simplify the management of user identity, devices, apps, and data with an integrated management experience. And we're also going to show you how you can plan Windows 10 deployments at scale and help you focus on what really matters, those readiness efforts and staying up to date and compliant. Oh, and one more thing. We're also going to keep you watching so that you can learn about our new co-management capabilities that are coming to Configuration Manager so that you can take advantage of cloud-based modern management with Configuration Manager at your own pace. So I'm joined today by Brad Anderson, Corporate Vice President.
That's great to be here. I love mechanics. I love what the mechanics team has been doing.
So with Microsoft 365, we've actually brought together Windows 10, Office 365, and Enterprise Mobility and Security. Lots of people might just think it's a product bundling, but it actually isn't. There's a lot more to it.
Microsoft 365 is so much more than just a name or a brand. Microsoft 365 is fundamentally changing how we build, define, and deliver products for our customers. We've literally been working on some of these scenarios for close to 5 years. I think we're literally looking at a time in a place in time right now, much like we were 25 years ago with Office, when Office came together and it fundamentally changed what people thought about productivity from that point forward. I think we're going to look back a couple of years from now at the launch of Microsoft 365, and it's going to have a similar impact where people go, that is what a modern workplace is. It's going to have that kind of an impact. Several years ago, we pulled teams together from across Microsoft, identity, management, security, Windows, the Office team, and we tried our best to define what we thought the needs were going to be in this modern workplace. And it was really clear to us back then that delivering on the needs of both users and IT was going to require us to engineer for both, and we're going to have to deeply integrate across all those technologies to really build that solution that is loved by users and trusted by IT. So Microsoft 365 pulls together the power of Windows 10, Office 365, and Enterprise Mobility and Security, and delivers that modern, secure workplace that is loved by users and trusted by IT.
Can you actually make this real by taking us through a scenario so that we can see how things change from both the users and IT's perspective?
You bet. So the first thing we're going to show you is how we're evolving the user experience as well as the IT experience for provisioning a new device. Now, historically, IT would receive the new devices as they came in. They would be the ones who would receive them from the manufacturer. They would image the device and get it ready to go to the user. But that just introduces complexity and time. And so what we do now with a Microsoft 365 powered device is that device can literally be delivered directly to your users. And one of the great things about that is that your users now have the ability to be able to open up that box and for that first time, that magic experience of taking a PC out of the box. And so with a part of this now, it can be shipped directly to the user. The user is going to be asked a couple of questions and we're automatically going to provision the device.
Okay, so can you show us what it looks like to go through that automatic provision?
You bet. So we actually have a version here so you can get a flavor of what the experience is. So the PC boots up from the first time. And then as it comes up, it's going to ask me 5 questions. What's my language? Where do I live? What's my keyboard preference? And then it's going to come back and ask me to join what Wi-Fi. Now, one of the most important things to point out here is you do not have to be on the corporate network. These are cloud services after all. So I could be anywhere on the planet. So I'm going to go ahead and join the Wi-Fi, put my key in. And now what's going to happen is it's actually communicating with the autopilot service. And it knows by the serial number of the device what company purchased it and who it's been assigned to. And the amazing thing about this is, look, it starts personalizing that experience for me within seconds of the time I first powered it on. Literally, I think your users are going to think this is magic because, the device knows it belongs to them within seconds. And you can see here, it provisions the device, the apps get deployed, the settings get deployed, your user's up and running in minutes. And so what used to take hours now takes minutes.
And so, Brad, what actually happened behind the scenes there for that all to work?
Yeah, so Autopilot provides a way to be able to import the serial number of the devices that are purchased, and then it gets assigned to a specific tenant or customer and the user. And one of the things that we announced today is we announced that 5 of the OEMs have now joined Microsoft in supporting Autopilot. And to kind of give you an idea, that accounts for 63% of all the PCs that are shipped out to commercial organizations. And of course, we hope all the OEMs join us.
That's amazing. That means most folks are going to be having one of those PCs.
Absolutely.
Okay, so what does it actually look like when we're on that PC now, which is a Windows Microsoft 365 powered device?
Okay, so first I'll take a look at it from the experience of the end user. So you're looking at my device here, and I've gone ahead and I've authenticated and using the Teams. I don't know how many of you are using Teams yet, but it really fundamentally changes how you create and how you do teamwork. Now, one of the things I want to point out here, it's personalized for me. It knows it's me. I got that great single sign-on experience. Here, my team wants me to take a look at a document. So I'm going to go ahead and open this into Word. Now, what I want to show you here is some of the innovations in Microsoft 365 on data protection. So what I want you to notice here is this document is marked as confidential. This is a success story that we've been working with Fruit of the Loom, who's been using Microsoft 365. We've been going back and forth and reviewing the document. Because it's not been approved yet, we've marked it as confidential. So things like I can come in here and take a look. You know, this document understands who can open it, it's self-protecting. But one of the great things about Microsoft 365 is the customer just approved this, so I now want to go ahead and change this from being confidential to making it publicly available. And just like that, you know, the watermark is gone. If I were to come back and take a look here in File, that protection is gone. It is that easy now for a user to be able to mark the confidential nature of a document and actually assign what the level of security should be applied to each one of the documents.
So that's a great simplified end user experience. We've really taken away a lot of the pain there. What have we actually done to simplify this for IT to make it easy to set up?
All right, so let's go take a look at some of the administrative experiences. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is how we actually configured that PC that was just imaged using Autopilot. So here you're looking at Intune, and I'm looking at all of the policies that I've configured for my Windows 10 baseline configuration. So you can see in here, I can come in here and I can do things like, I can come in and go set all of the Windows Defender settings, but all of the settings that are exposed by Windows 10, you can now manage and control through Intune. Okay, and those of you who are on Config Manager and you're looking to move into this modern management, we're going to show you how easy we've made that, but this is the next evolution of that architecture. Let's take a look now at the applications. And so first, I want to point out here that Microsoft 365 enables us to manage applications on all your platforms, you know, iOS, Android, Windows. Let's go take a look at one of the new innovations we're talking about here at the event, and that is now the ability for us to be able to manage Office Pro Plus as a suite rather than as individual products. So I can come in here now. I'm looking at my policy to deploy Office Pro Plus. You can go and take a look at the applications that you want to deploy, so I could be selective if I want to deploy everything. I can come in here and actually define the settings for Office. But now, in a modern way, you can now manage these applications that are coming from the various stores. And instead of having to treat them as individual apps, you can now treat it as a suite.
Very cool.
So many of you use scripting inside a Config Manager. And one of the things that you've asked for as you've looked at the MDM capabilities of managing is you've wanted a way to script so you can do things on Windows 10 devices that the MDM layer did not enable. So new, announcing at the event today, is what we call PowerShell scripts. The actual name of this is Intune Management Extensions. And this extends the capabilities of Intune, and for example, now allows you to create a PowerShell script. That PowerShell script can deploy apps, it can set settings, it can do all the things you would want to do on a device. You just simply point to the PowerShell script, and then you can configure it and apply it, and you now have much more flexibility as you move from the way you've done things in the past to now doing it from the cloud through Intune. Microsoft 365 is all about empowering that modern workplace for users across all the devices that they love. And so we look at iOS, Android, Windows, and announcing at the event today that Jamf has joined us for deep Mac management, and we believe all of those need to be managed and enabled by Microsoft 365.
So in the same portal, you've actually got access to be able to activate Windows security. You've got the ability to do app deployment. You also showed us information protection. How easy was it actually to activate all of that?
Okay, Azure Information Protection is something revolutionary for us. You think about it for a minute. Historically, writes to files have been stored in the file system. With Azure Information Protection, we actually store the files, or the writes in the file itself, so that file becomes self-protecting. What I'm going to show you here is the administrative experience to set up AIP. And what you can do is you can come in here, you can set up your own custom groups that align to how your company wants to protect it. What does confidential mean? What does extremely confidential mean? And then your users can select the appropriate tag or setting as they're creating the application. With Microsoft 365, we can automatically auto-classify based upon rules that you give us, but it literally is that easy to set up. What I want to show you here is some of the work that we have done in terms of how we are helping organizations upgrade. And so one of the key things about Microsoft 365 is we're able to give you views now into the data that we collect on your tenant, as well as views by aggregating data across the board. Specifically, I want to walk through one scenario, and then at 4 o'clock today, we're going to go through a lot more detail on this. So the first thing that we want to do here is we want to give you a view of how we enable you to actually upgrade your devices. The biggest challenge associated with upgrading historically from one version of Windows to another has been application compatibility testing. That's the single largest bucket of cost. And so what we now give you is the ability to help you identify where you should spend your precious time at. So what you're looking at here in this console is a couple of places. So first of all, that number that says 503 there, what we're telling you in this particular scenario, to upgrade all your PCs, there's 503 applications we think you need to go take a look at. If you take a look down in there, we actually help you classify where to spend your time. And there's one line in there that says, I think it's 279, that actually is pointing to the fact that we actually see those applications that are running around the globe in your peers and other organizations. We see it working. And so we're telling you, you don't have to worry about testing those because we already validated that they're working. But that blade right there that has 136 and 579 on it, this is my favorite blade of this experience. Because what it's saying there is, if you go look at these 136 drivers and apps and go through the process to make sure that they're validated, you'll unblock 10% of your remaining PCs to upgrade to Windows 10. If you look at the 579, you will unblock 80% of your devices to go up to Windows 10. Now remember, end of service for Windows 7 is less than 1,000 days away, so all of you are going to be going through this, okay? This is going to be one of the ways you can accelerate your deployment to Windows 10. And then we track it for you. And you see here in this donut, you can see that as you go do your work, we'll automatically identify the PCs that are ready to be upgraded. If you take a look at there at the very bottom, it says export. That automatically exports all that data to Config Manager, and Config Manager will automatically go and target all of your devices and upgrade them for you. Also notice there that there's that little red mark that says 5. What we're telling you is these devices will not upgrade to Windows 10. Don't even try it. And so we help you also understand where you shouldn't go to upgrade, and you should actually replace the hardware. And that's learning that's come from the 500 million PCs that we've upgraded to Windows 10 around the globe. Now, the other thing we've done here is we've done some more integration with Office and Office analytics. And so the biggest question we hear from all of yours upgrading to a new version of Office is, what plugins are my users using? Because I have to make sure their plugins are available in the new version of Office. Right here, you get that prioritized list of Office plugin usage ranked by usage. And so you can very quickly take action and make sure that you're doing the things that are most commonly used by your users.
That's great. So you actually mentioned that not only do we have this capability of looking at the existing estate, we also have Configuration Manager, which is out there and managing a lot of machines right now. Let's talk a little bit about co-management with Configuration Manager.
So first, let's just take a moment and celebrate the impact that Configuration Manager has had on the lives of millions of IT professionals. This summer is the 25th anniversary of Configuration Manager. Okay, yeah, that's pretty amazing. And this last week, we passed 100 million devices actively being managed by Current Branch. We're just a little over halfway through upgrading the configuration management installed base. We still have more than 1 million new devices coming in every single week. But I'll tell you, 25 years, 100 million devices, that is an amazing impact. Now that's where all of us are starting at, including Microsoft. We're all in a world where we have Active Directory, Configuration Manager, and Group Policy. We want to move into this modern way of doing it, but you've told us, and we've seen this, it's just too hard to try to do it all at once. It's risky, and there's no way to walk in and one morning and say, we're going to move to AAD and to Intune. And so what we have done now is we've made it easier for you by forming a bridge, and we call that bridge co-management. And what that enables us to do now is a single Windows 10 device can be joined to Active Directory and Azure Active Directory at the same time. This will be made available in the fall release of Windows. What that means now is that device can be managed by both Config Manager and Intune at the same time. So you start with what you're doing today, and then what you can do is you can start to move a workload at a time. So you start doing device compliance from the cloud. Then maybe you go start doing your software updates from the cloud. Then you do software distribution from the cloud. But this enables you to do it in little bite-sized chunks. It's less risky, and it's actually going to help you accelerate this movement to modern management from the cloud through what we call co-management. Now, one of the unique things about Config Manager and Intune is it's one team that builds it. And so you have this communication that's always happening between the two of those, and we actually know on every single object, on every single attribute, who the authoritative source is. Is it Intune or is it Config Manager? Because we want to make sure that you don't have to worry about conflicting policies. And so that's one of the things that as you move from Config Manager to Intune for your modern management, a great benefit enabling it. So let me actually give you a view of what it looks like from the administrative experience. This right here is a view inside of the SCCM console. This will be made available in the 1710 build of Config Manager. And notice what we've done here. You can now take a look at workloads. We're going to start with these three, and over time, this is going to expand to 8 or 10 different workloads. And if I want to now move a workload to the cloud, it literally is just as simple as dragging and dropping that slider bar, and I can say, hey, I want to pilot this one, so I'm going to kind of have some in Intune and some in Config Manager. If I want to move the whole organization over, I just drag that sliding bar all the way over. Let's do it again. And just like that, you start moving to the cloud. You start moving workload by workload to the cloud. And you're moving to modern IT, where we can now apply all the power of Microsoft 365 in the cloud to help you.
That's a really clever way of doing it, just being able to move a slider to be able to set the authority to a different location. I love the fact that we've actually got the ability to pilot in there as well. It means that nobody has to take a big bang change. They can do it at their own pace.
Yeah. You know, IT, we don't like taking those big leaps. We like to do things that are a little more controlled, little things that are less risky. But by doing that, you actually accelerate.
So can you tell me just why might people want to be doing modern management? What is so great about it?
You know, by moving to modern management, organizations can massively simplify the work that they have to do. And in so doing it, they make themselves more secure, they decrease their costs, and they actually give their users the best experience possible. You know, there's an elegance about simplicity. The fewer moving parts that you have that have all been integrated to work together give you both the best experience, but it also makes you more secure. I'll give you an engineering perspective on this. We're able to build and release in these incredibly rich integrated scenarios across Microsoft 365 the services. We're delivering capabilities that we've never been able to do on-prem. Each of the Microsoft 365 services are constantly being updated, but because they're cloud services and they're all running in the cloud, we can actually update them one by one across the globe and do it in a controlled way that allows us to, as long as each of the services gives a northbound SLA and an agreement on compatibility, they can all iterate iteratively, but we bring together a collective security and a collective integrated solution for our customers.
It's a really great way of being able to manage that entire service. And I think it means that people don't have to deploy lots and lots of kind of hard to configure things on premises.
Yeah, you know, in the past, you think about what you had to do as an organization. In order to take advantage of a new set of capabilities coming out from Microsoft, you maybe had to start with updating your servers, your databases, Config Manager itself. You know, and so there was all these things that you had to build in order to deliver a bunch of innovation. I'll tell you, we worked hard over the years to build these integrated scenarios that crossed everything across the company. But the reality is getting all of that deployed was very, very hard for you. But now you do it in the cloud. We're able to do all that work on your behalf. It's our job to update the services. It's our job to make sure they're integrating end to end. You just get the value of this. It increases your impact and it increases your ability to get out new capabilities quicker. One of the things that we just fundamentally believe is that human hands and human heads, minds, can no longer keep up with everything that they have to do. And so you're going to continue to see us take these integrated scenarios across Microsoft 365, and we're going to focus on how we empower you and how we give you insights for you to be more efficient and more effective, how we better secure your environment, and how we deliver the absolute best experience for your users across all the devices that they want to love, or that they love and that they want to use. So we're looking forward to your feedback, and we're going to go do this together.
Thank you very much for coming along to the Microsoft Mechanics live stage. And thank you, everybody, for watching the show. That's all we've got time for now. We'll see you next time.